Hello all, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will see why capacitors allow AC signals. So let's get started. To understand why capacitors allow AC signal, you first need to understand what a capacitor is. Then you'll need to understand what an AC signal is. And finally, you'll also have to understand how capacitors behave with DC. So I have done two videos in my channel, one to explain what an AC and a DC signal is, so please look at that first. And there is one more video which shows how capacitors behave with DC. So once you see both of those videos, I think you will be in a good state to watch this video. If you already know how a capacitors behave with DC and how to visualize AC signals, you can continue with this video. So let's take only one plate of the capacitor. Let's assume this is one of the plate of the capacitor and a wire goes to that. And this is the electron. As we all know, in an AC signal, electrons, they'll move towards the capacitor plate, sit on the capacitor for some time, and then again come back in the same direction. And they keep on doing this forever. They will sit on the plate and they'll come back from the plate. This is a very high level idea of what electron does in an AC signal with the capacitor, but to understand a little bit more deeply, electrons, when they are moving towards the plate, they'll start accumulating, and when more and more electrons wants to sit in the plate on the same direction, there will be some kind of resistance offering. So the very first electron, or the very first set of electron which try to sit on the plate, can move onto the plate very easily, and the electrons which come later, they have some kind of resistance due to the electrons already present here. They try to repel them away. After some time, they just change the direction and move back in the opposite direction towards the wire. So now let me show a full circuit and probably you can understand what will happen. So if this is the capacitor and this is an AC signal, electrons just try to move, sit on the plate and come back. Move, sit on the plate and come back. Overall, when you see, it looks like electrons in the circuit are oscillating like this. But they usually don't move for such a long distance. What electrons do it? They usually, the ones near the capacitor, charge the capacitor, and the ones next to the electrons fill the gap made by those electrons. This keeps on going on, and a chain of electrons move in this direction. And in the opposite cycle of the AC, the chain of electrons will move again in this direction. Therefore, even though the capacitors have a physical gap in between their plates, electrons need not across this empty space here. What they do is they just sit on the plate for some time and then again change the direction to come back to the wire. And that is the reason why capacitors allow AC, even though they have a physical gap between them. So that's all for this video. In my next video, I'll be explaining why the impedance of capacitors vary with frequency of AC signals. Till then, stay tuned and subscribe to the channel. Thank you. Yeah.